This is Gale Nelson, President and CEO of Big Brothers Big Sisters Miami, the host of The Game of Life.
Welcome to The Game of Life Mentoring Podcast. I'm your host, Gale Nelson, President and CEO of Big Brothers Big Sisters Miami. And tonight is all about the college journey. Tonight we talk to four littles who will share with us their journey, their hopes, their dreams. And you know what's great about this? It's scholarship season. And I'm sure they've applied for various scholarships, but the most important thing is they want to do something bigger. So tonight, I want them to introduce themselves. And so it's great having you all in studio. Welcome to the Game of Life Mentoring Podcast. Give us your name and your school, and we'll start from there.
My name is Kiara, and I go to Miami Jackson Senior High School.
Home of the Generals, if I'm not mistaken.
Yep.
Welcome, Kiara. Let's move that microphone over a little bit.
My name is Brianna. I go to Slam Miami.
Slam Miami. What's Slam's mascot?
A Titan.
A Titan.
Yeah.
All right. So we got the General, we got Titan, so we are ready for battle. Excellent. Excellent.
My name is Ozzy Pichardo, and I go to Coral Gables Senior High School.
So Coral Gables, give me the mascot.
Cavaliers.
Cavaliers. Again, there's a theme here. Welcome, Ozzy.
Hi, my name is Kanaya Brown. I attend at Miami Edison Senior High School.
Miami Edison, home of the?
Red Raiders.
The Red Raiders. We got Raiders, Cavaliers, Titans, and Generals. Well, first of all, I want to just thank all of you. And when you get a chance, I want you to thank your parents, those who work with you at your respective schools, because somebody signed you all up to be littles for Big Brothers, Big Sisters. And what we do, and I'm the baby boy in the family, and I understand the need for mentorship. And I'll just share with you all, just to put it in perspective. As we think about mentoring, a mentor is a trusted friend and counsel. Somebody takes time out to spend time with you. So I want to thank each of you, because it takes two. You all are part of a relationship. So let me just ask each of you, and we're going to start on this end. How long have you been matched? And what have you learned with your big? And what have you taught your big?
So I've been matched for 3 years now. I got blessed with the lady named Miss Laura. Miss Laura taught me so many things that I can't even count on my fingers. And I definitely taught her some things. And we still talk. Every single day.
What do you all talk about?
We just talk about things that she helped me with, either scholarship, me going to college, and she also gets on a personal level with, like, being an actual big sister to me. Mm. Like, anything that I've needed or I've reached out to her, she was always there. Even sometimes if it was nighttime, if I called her, she always answered. She always been there to help me out.
That's what sisterhood's all about.
Yes.
So you think you're going to be friends with her for a long time?
Definitely.
When does it expire?
I don't think never.
I love that. I set you up, didn't I? That's beautiful. Ozzy, how long have you been matched, young man?
3 years. I've been matched with, his name is Jason Hibber. He's a firefighter, and me and him get along very well, actually. I just texted him the other day because me and him have a lot in common, like soccer for one, and they have a tournament right now, the Champions League. My team got knocked out, and I had to text him that it was very depressing, you know?
Yeah, that sports thing, it can kind of get all our blood pressure up. So that's good. And so what has he taught you? What are some things you taught one another?
Well, I've talked to him, like, about, like, my future, like in terms of, like, career path.
Okay.
So he's a firefighter. I was intrigued in that for a little bit. Like, at first, so he told me, like, their day-to-day lives, like, what they do, like, what to expect. And then I texted him also for help in terms of, to write essays for other scholarships that are not for other ones. Okay. And he's helped me a lot in those perspectives.
That's great. So, ladies, in no particular order, whoever wants to go first, how long have you been matched, and what have you learned? What have you taught and or learned? I'm just curious.
I've been matched with her mommy for 2 years. She's always been a big help. She's here with me right now. Just another example of all the way she supports me. It's like being paired with her mommy is just looking like into a future me. I feel like we're really alike in multiple ways. She's really shy. I'm really shy. We both started our young lives similarly. I've worked at a young age. She works at a young age. So I feel like I've taught her many things about the opportunities that she could have for her daughters that she probably didn't know because she doesn't have at her age, but I do now, so she could pass them on to her children.
So it's true sisterhood.
It's true sisterhood.
I love that. And for somebody that's shy, you're doing an excellent job.
Thank you.
How long you been matched, and what have you learned and or taught?
I've been matched with my big for like a year.
Okay.
And her name is Erica. She's right over there. She taught me like a lot of stuff. Like, she taught me how to do sign language a little bit.
Okay.
And she just like showed me around like all the opportunities that I could do in like colleges and give me like experience or like tell me what I'm supposed to do and like lead me there. And it's like, it's the best. It's really the best.
All of you have mentioned opportunity. All of you have mentioned the relationship you have with your big, whether it's 1 year or 3 years. And to have bigs that either brought you here tonight or just accompany you and support you in so many ways, and you support them. Tell me what you want to be when you grow up. Or what's that next chapter look like in terms of after high school at Edison, at Coral Gables, at SLAM and Jackson? I get all the schools correct? So what's next after the chapter? Let's start on this end now. What's the career goal, or what's next?
My career goal, I want to be a businesswoman.
Like, go ahead.
I want to sell stuff, like, through entrepreneur and, like, you know, reach out to people that need. And, like, I want to do real estate, sell houses, because I really like to design houses and, like, you know, make it how people want to, you know, live in it to, like, feel comfortable, like they're supposed to be there. And that's really it. That's
so you want to sell?
Yes.
So sell me something right now. Give me your pitch. Give me a sales pitch. What you create the product, sell me something right now.
Okay.
Come on.
Like a suit cleaner.
A suit cleaner. Okay.
Yeah. Like, it's going to make your suit clean, you know, look fresh every single day, you know, make it steam up, get a tie, you know, look good.
Come on.
Mirror, fresh, come on. Clean, your shoes shining, good.
So.
Yeah.
I love it. I love that swagger. I love that swagger. What's next chapter? What's your career goal? What's
next? I would like to pursue a career in nursing, hopefully a trauma nurse. I want to be able to help people, not just physically, but emotionally, because I know nurses do partake a lot in that. So I just want to pass it along, knowing that we need it a lot in our current world situations.
First responders, nurses, that is absolutely awesome.
For me, it would have to be civil engineering. It's been something that's I've been intrigued my whole life, mostly because of my dad, because he works in the construction life. So I hope to pursue that and one day work with him as business partners too. So, but you never know what life will take for you.
I love that. And certainly last but not least, what's the next chapter? What's that career goal?
My next chapter is to become a teacher, an elementary educator. The reason why I chose that is I didn't have that. That was not my first choice. My first choice was to be a lawyer. But I heard somebody say one day, you know, do what makes you love, what you love, right? And when I thought about it, I said, you know what, I want to be a teacher. And the reason why I want to be a teacher is because not to be a teacher inside those walls, but to be outside those walls. And I realized they start from a young age. So when you have little kids, you have to be able to guide them and lead them somewhere. When you teach in high schoolers, you can't really do that because they already know what they want. I'm a high schooler, so
the high schoolers are acquired taste.
Right.
So take some time.
I had to learn that, you know, it starts from a young age, and that's where I want to be. I want to be able to lead children the right way.
I commend all of you. From sales, which requires confidence and planning and discipline and focus. A nurse, saving lives. Civil engineer, you're building. Teacher, you're building. Young minds. So I commend all of you. So now all of the things you all want to do, business, nursing, civil engineer, teacher, you got to go to school for that. You got to go to college, get some trainings and certifications. So tell me about your scholarship process. Have you all applied for any? Raise your hand if you applied for any scholarships. Everybody's applied for scholarships. How important to your to you and your family is a scholarship? Ozzy, let's start with you.
So scholarship for my family is a big deal, since, like, you know, depending on where you go to, it could be a pretty big debt, and you would have to pay almost your whole life, even with the profession that you choose. And if you're not blessed enough to have a family that earns a lot of money, it takes a toll. So scholarships help you in that regards.
Scholarship, how important it would be to you and your family?
It's very a big deal to me and my family. One thing my mom always tells me is, you better get signed up for those scholarships because you need it.
That sounds like mama talk.
Yes. My family don't have a lot of funds to, you know, support me in my college, but they do support me on receiving opportunities. And I feel like every scholarship is an opportunity, even if it takes so long to write an essay. But it comes out to be a great deal.
It's worth it, isn't it?
Yes.
How important is a scholarship to you and your family?
Scholarships are really important for my family, not only as a financial burden, but personally, because not a lot of people have given us the opportunity to be able to take your children to school for, like, such a low amount of price. And it just relieves a financial burden, and it allows us to just show who we are as people and as a culture when it's not given to us as easily as other people.
Gotta work. That's, I appreciate that. A scholarship, how important to you and to your family?
It's important to my family because I see my dad just, like, working hard. And it's like he has to pay off all this stuff. And, like, I don't want to add that to, like, his stuff. So I need, like, scholarships to help me and get to the college that I want to go to and, like, help my family. Because, like, they was, like, at the lowest. So, like, that's really all.
So that's all right. You said a lot with that. So all of you want to enter a profession, as we said earlier, that means a lot to society. And all of you want to help your family. All of you have a big in your corner, literally, to support you along the way. But there are those in our community that want to talk to you as well. I'm pleased, and just stay right where you are, because we got some special guests with us tonight. And this is not a game show, this is the game of life. This is a real deal. So come on in, we got some special guests that wanna just come in and say hello to you all. And we'll just go ahead and push that mic up a little bit. And we got our friends from Coca-Cola, Coke Florida, as a matter of fact. So we're gonna give them the opportunity. This is live on the Game of Life Mentoring Podcast. You all look like somebody just broke into the studio. Trust me, I'm here with you at Big Brothers because we never leave our littles by themselves. And so, gentlemen, take it away.
How you doing, kids?
Good.
Be watching you. My name is Carlos Diaz-Granados. This is Scotty Walker. And on behalf of Coke Florida and the Florida Prepaid Foundation, we're here to let you know that you guys just got a scholarship. Yes. You just won a scholarship.
Yes, you can scream. You do whatever, make them noise. They're in shock. They're in shock right now.
How about that? How do you?
I'm almost, but anyway.
All right, that feel good?
Yeah.
It feel good knowing I heard the stories about the burden, the responsibility, the financial burdens. How about that's lifted? You don't have to worry about that. All you have to do is focus on the next chapter of your life. So in order to kick this off in true Coke Florida fashion, I'm going to hand you all a card. I'm going to stay in front of the mic here. Thank you. Feel free to open that up because I'm going to talk about what's in there. So we're going to kick this off by inviting you and three of your loved ones to Orlando to spend the day with us at Universal.
What?
Oh. How's that? That's good? You like
make
that?
Make some noise, everybody. Make some noise. We got Biggs here tonight. We got your family here tonight. One mama's going to pass out tonight. That is for sure. Are you all still in shock? How does it feel?
It good.
Great. Good.
It's okay to smile. Brianna, how you feeling? You're like soaking it up.
Oh, man.
So we'll talk a little bit more about the details, but just know it'll be a great experience. You all will get to hang out with me, Carlos, Diana, the whole Coke Florida team. But think about this. This is truly just, you are the recipient of the work that you do every day, working with your bigs, working with your family. This is the output of doing good things. So we're proud to connect with you all, the community. So we wish you the very best.
I want to do something special. You all stay right where you are. And we don't have room for everybody to come over here, but I want either a big or a one member of the family to stand behind your child. Stand behind somebody to get give me a representative. I want somebody with each of them because we're going, because I know what we're about to do. So you can hug, you can kiss, don't go crazy. That's the one I'm worried about right there. But that's all right. This is real emotion. It's all right. It's all right. Mama, it's okay. He's like, Mom, chill out a little bit. Don't you start crying. We want real. This is, there you go. go. Go ahead. You can hug and kiss. It's all right. It's all right. See, this, let me say this to each of you. Oof. This is what Big Brothers Big Sisters is all about. To the bigs that are here, thank you, thank you, thank you. And you all trust us with your children. Coca-Cola is special to me because I was a senior in high school. You see these eyes starting to light, glossom? This is real. I'm the baby boy, and I applied for a Coke scholarship my senior year in high school. Not because I looked for it, but a high school counselor brought it and handed it to me in the hallway. And so I got my bachelor's degree because of Coca-Cola.
Wow.
So to be here tonight with all of you is very, very special. So on behalf of Big Brothers, Big Sisters, congratulations. Hug them again, hug them again, hug them again. They don't mind, they're huggable. So congratulations. And let me just ask you, we're gonna close out this podcast with a word from each of you. This is your night. We're all here because of you. And so I know as high school students, there's a coolness, but just tell me how you're feeling. And there's no right or wrong answers. Just how are you feeling right now? We're gonna start down here.
Blessed. That's the only word that's blessed. It's truly blessed.
It's all right. It's all right.
I would have to say ecstatic. That's really much all I can say too. Just like she said, because I did not expect this to happen today. Really not expect this. Great opportunity. Thank you so much.
Absolutely. How you feeling?
The word really is blessed. You guys are doing the Lord's work. You guys have my mom crying. Just feels good.
It's all right. It's all right. How you feeling?
The same way. Blessed, and I'm so shocked. It's just surprised. It's just.
So these great people in red, Coca-Cola, we're going to let them close us out. You know, I've heard, there's a slogan. I don't know if the slogan still, Coke is it, the real thing. But so this is it tonight.
Yeah.
And the real thing is mentorship plus scholarship. And as you all grow and you graduate, that's going to be citizenship. So Coca-Cola, close us out.
Most people don't know this, but the Coke system is a franchise system. Much like a McDonald's, Burger King franchise, you can own a Coke franchise. So obviously it's a different game, different scale, but we happen to work for one of two black-owned Coke bottlers. The bottler that we work for, the ownership is Troy Taylor. Troy owns all of Florida, with the exception of the Panhandle. So I'm gonna share a little story about this. So we have 5,000 employees, but the beauty of being a business owner in Florida is to provide the economic engine, jobs. And so I hear your stories, I hear your future endeavors of business and want to be teachers, et cetera. Like, just know that you all have a connection, a conduit to Coke, Florida. So in the future, whether that's jobs, careers while you're in school, career after school, you know three people that can help you out. So think about, I like to say it this way, there's a lot that goes into putting that product on the shelf, from engineering. We have engineers that work for us. We have the whole gamut that helps bring that product to the table. And so there could be a future with you for you working for Coke Florida. So just want to share that with you. This is part of what we do, our commitment to connect with the community that where we live, work, and play. So Carlos, any words?
I just want to say, guys, make the most of this. It is amazing the journey that you've been. I am in awe of your commentary and your outlook. Make the best of it. Take it for all it's worth and enjoy it. So go for it.
Well, certainly.
No looking back.
We can't thank you enough for just taking time out to visit and to bless the lives of these four littles and their respective families. The tears, the joy speak for itself. And I will say to you, as we close out this podcast, my first job after I graduated from high school was carrying CO2 tanks for Coca-Cola, because they gave me a summer job. See, I love the organic nature. And because that put money in my pocket, they paid the tuition, but I had money in my pocket. So thank you all for being here. Parents, thank you for being here. Yeah. We can't thank you all enough. So as we close out the Game of Life Mentoring Podcast, special scholarship edition, Coke is it. It's the real thing. And these littles are going to do some big things, because the stage is never too big for our littles. In the Game of Life, everybody makes the team, but how you play is up to you. Let's go. This is the Game of Life.